We perform three kinds of behavior. We human beings perform three types of behavior. One, we take effort to get something. It's called pravritti. We take effort to get rid of something. We take effort to remain indifferent about something. Udasini. But please note the fourth sentence. All behaviors are prompted by knowledge. Whether it is pravritti or nivritti or udasinya, all the three are prompted by knowledge. Why? What is the function of knowledge? What does knowledge do? What does cognition do? It presents the world before you with a name and a form. With a name, this is a table, you say. It's a form and a name. And then if I need to write something, then I know I can use it. So, all the human behaviors, therefore, and therefore, beautiful statement in Sanskrit, you see, sarva devahara pravartakam jnana. So, knowledge will present the world before me, and next, I may want to have it. I may like to get rid of it, or I may remain indifferent about it. In any of the three situations, unless there is cognition, this can never happen. And therefore, cognition or jnana is the pravartaka, inducer of all human behavior. We know, we desire, and then we mentally prepare ourselves, and then we act. Jnanam, Icha, Kriti, Kriya. What is the story? What is our experience? Sometimes I'm successful, and sometimes I meet failure. What does it mean? Success and failure. What is the meaning of success and failure? Jnana has shown me X. And if I go and get X, success. Jnana has presented me Y. Jnana has presented me Y. And I go there and I see there is X. Failure. Why should such thing happen? Because we have already said that jnana is the prompting factor. It is the jnana who has prompted me for behavior. So the success and failure of the behavior has to be contributed to the prompter, jnana. And therefore, the jnana who has led me to success is safala pravritti janaka jnana. Is categorized like that. And the jnana would lead me to failure is vipala pravritti janaka jnana. If you read Sanskrit, you know now, your vocabulary will increase. In your own mother tongue. Why? Why such thing happened? Such success and failure. Because in one case, the cognition presents the world as it is, X as X, and hence there was success. And in another case, the cognition does not present world as it is, X as Y, and therefore there was failure. Thus, cognition of or jnana has to be two of two. So we must classify jnana into two categories. cognition, or yathartha jnana in Sanskrit, or I told you, safala pravritti janaka jnana. False cognition, ayathartha jnana, or vipala pravritti janaka jnana. The cognition, this is X, sometimes occurs when X is really X, isn't so? But sometimes it occurs also when X is not X, but Y. This is also jnana. You need to analyze. And you have seen just now that it is this jnana who has prompted you for training. So you need to analyze this jnana also. In such cases, we treat the first cognition as true and the second cognition as false, since it becomes a contradictory cognition. It is. And how do I know it is contradictory? When I reached there, it showed me why. It showed me why-ness means why, no? I could see why through why-ness. But what I found, X. And therefore, what sentence comes out from my mouth? This is not X. This is not Y. So a cognition which is followed by a cognition which is contradictory to each other. This is X followed by this is not X. This is Y followed by this is not Y. When such cases come, then we have to analyze. We have to declare that this is a false cognition. So we need, point is, we need to classify jnana into two. Jnana, which is pramana, which is true cognition, and jnana, which is apramana, a false cognition. Why that logic I have given to you? Because these two jnanas prompted my behavior, one led to success, the other led to failure. And that cannot be accounted for unless I differentiate between the first jnana from the second jnana. And that is why we need to posit this second category of jnana, and that category is apramana, or a false cognition. Prabhakara now comes, and he declares, all this is nonsense. The Prabhakara school of Purvamimamsa, however, believes that there is nothing called contradicted or contradictory cognition. Now see the bold step. Vyavahara is problematic. The jnana is not problematic. Bhavatam grihepi sahiva katha. Even in Ramanuja's. So all cognitions are true, he says. There is no doubtful cognition, even.
No samshaya.
No samshaya. There is nothing called illusion, Brahma. And one logician of Kashmir in 9th century AD, around 890 or so, Jayanta Bhatta is his name. He wrote an encyclopedic work called Nyayamanjari. He writes this, just to see. I will translate it in English, don't worry. But Sanskrit you have to listen. Yadatu na vadho nama jagati kaschit api bodha. We have said that there is nothing called vadha, there is no contradictory cognition. Tada kim sadharmyat samsherate pramatara, then how can there be samshaya doubt? Two categories, then you will be matching someone to be true. some continue to be false. But when the category of false formation itself is not there, then where is the question of doubt? Where is the question of false cognition at all? This is being presented by an AI, a logician, the position of Prabhakar. This was the mode of, I told dialogical mode, no? So you have to, if I have to counter, first I have to present the other's view. So Prabhakara's view is clarified here. This is what he wants, what he says. Anapekshamanah katham paratah pramanyam pratipadyantam. And if he does not require anything, because the main aim was to declare that the Vedas are self-valid. It does not require external factor to validate Veda. That was their problem. In that context, that was the context of the debate. And say, it is all not necessary. We don't need to validate it. Validate when? If there is a second category called false cognition. There is no false cognition, there is no question of validity at all. So seeking for validity. Then say, okay, then what do you mean by contradiction? Now let us, so they now go on discussing the what is meant by contradiction. What is contradiction after all? And several definitions have been provided. Now you can see how difficult. Therefore, there is nothing called contradictions. So contradiction is not definable by you. You have already provided so many definitions, none of holds water. And therefore, I rule out there is nothing called a contradictory cognition. Falsity of a cognition is to be decided on the basis of the falsity of its content. Then the logicians come in, say, no, we have to, okay, for the timing, let us set aside, cognition cannot be false. But what about the content of that cognition? If the content of the cognition is false, then it presented silver and I got conscious. What about that? We encounter three types of entities: real, fictitious, neither real nor fictitious, sat, asat, and sadasat. Vilakshana, a third category. These are the contributions of philosophical systems. The third one is of Advaita. Thus, there can be three types of cognitions. That whose content is real. So now we will decide, we'll analyze, taking into account the content of the cognition. Cognition we will not touch for the time. Content, the content is real or not. Content is fictitious or not, and content is inexplicable or not. So, the tradition discusses theories of error under these three broad heads. Sat khyati vada. Sat means real, existent, present in this world. Asat khyati, asat means fictitious. Kapushpa, rabbit's horn. So, fictitious a category which your mind can create. We behave with such things. Existent things, real, sat. So, sat, asat, and anirvachaniya, inexplicable. Neither sat category nor asat category. Sadasa vilakshana. And accordingly, the theories are called Satkhyadivada, Asatkhyadivada, and Ananvachaniya Khyadivada. Satkhyadivada,
I have already told you where sat means existent, with which we behave in this world. For instance, when one takes conch shell to be silver,
in this case, so this is your shukti, and what has appeared here is rajatattva, and so you call this is rajatattva, this is silver.
By mistake, and say this is silver, you see. Silver does exist in the jewelry shop. It is not fictitious, no? It may not be here in front of you, but it is not fictitious, like a rabbit's horn. It is found somewhere in the world. So one category of this entity. And so, it is existent in the world and not any mental construction or fictitious. Thus, the theories of error based on Satkyami are of six types. Akhyadi, Viparita Akhyadi, Anatha Akhyadi, Yathartha Akhyadi, Sadasat Khyati and Atma Khyati. In all, you mistake something which exists in this world. Sometimes outside, even sometimes inside. Atma Khyati. So, you mistake X as Y. Both X and Y are existent in this world. I am running a little, allow me. So there are six types of things with which we behave, but these things are very much present in this world. So there can be false cognitions arising regarding such things. You mistake, you commit error. What has happened, Prabhakara says, Prabhakara's explanation. Why I say that this is silver is not an illusion, is not a false cognition. He gives explanation. He says, this has been experienced. When you open your eyes, then only there was something, X. You open your eyes, and then only such a cognition arises or not. So this is an experience. First thing, you agree. This is anubhava. Okay. This has been experienced through the sense, so silver has been remembered. And the silver has been remembered. Remembrance is jnana. Anubhava also is jnana. So this is not a single jnana. It's a composite one. A part of it is experience and the part of it is remembrance. Remembrance also is true. Experience also is true. Where is the question of a false cognition of silver? So we say there is nothing called any cognition called false. So, this silver is not one cognition, but a combination of two cognitions, namely an experience and a remembrance. Viparita khyati is the term used by Bhatta. Viparita, I summarize it this way, that which is present before you, opposite of that appears in your cognition. Present before you is shukti. What has appeared is rajata, silver. So it is viparita khyati. However, Bhatta treats this as one jnana and not two jnanas. And therefore, this jnana, he calls it as false. Anatha khyati is same, almost same of viparita khyati. This is held by Nyaya school of Nyaya. I presume. Yathartha khyati. Yathartha khyati is of Ramanujan. Now, to summarize, there is a method of in the metaphysics of the system called Panchikarana Prakriya. There are five elements: Akasha, Vayu, Agni, Water, Prithvi. These are the five basic elements called Pancha Mahabhuta. Each Mahabhuta contains some portion of the other. So even in the Shukti, there is a portion of Rajata. So he says that he is knowing what is present there only. Because of, and this theory is called Panchikaran. In the earlier, he was saying Panchikaran. So, each one carries the elements of the remaining four. So there is no question of not knowing the silver in the Shukti. Then Sadasat Khyati. This is of the Jainas. Multiple angles of looking at the reality. Anekantavada. Syadavada. So anekantava. So from this angle the reality is like this. From another perspective the reality may be different. So in this way, you cannot declare this is asat, false. So this is how they say. Then Atma Khyati is of the Yogacara school of Buddhist philosophers. The world is not outside, but world is inside me. Every one of us is carrying the world. The world is inside. What is the inside? The consciousness, jnana itself. So jnana is Atma, the self. And that itself is projected outside. My mind projects the inner world out of. And so all our the external world is called Samvriti Sat. Just like Shankara's Maya. So outside, they do not exist outside, they all exist in me. But because of Anadi Vasana, I project that inner world and outer for behavior. This is the philosophy of Buddhist school called Yogacara school of Buddhism. There are four schools: Vaibhashika, so Prantika, Yogacara, and Madhyamika. These are the and their views. Asat Khyati, the theory is of Madhyamika school and also of Madhvas. So Madhyamikas deny the Shunyavadin, void, everything is void. What is the meaning of void? Nothing in the world that you characterize by a form and a name, no feature can be established which can give that name and form. Swabhava Shunya is called. Shunya means zero. That is absence of all properties, characterizing properties, by which we characterize an entity. And that is the nature of. So the world is all void, shunya. And therefore, what is appearing is asat, fictitious. So Madhyamikas had this. And then Abhinava Anyata Khyati is of Madhvas. They are realist. The world is real. But the silver that he sees in the Shukti, the relationship is alika. And therefore, this is called Abhinava Anyata Khyativada, or the Madhva school of Vedanta. And finally, the Shankara Advaitin's view, Anirvachaniya Khyati. He has posited a category of entity which cannot be explained. So inexplicable. Nirvachana is explanation. Anirvachaniya, that which cannot be explained. A third category. So Nayayikas are asking what is the need of that and all that. That's a debate. Forget about. Then my observations, some of them I will tell you. I think you may have started agreeing with me now. We have inherited a very rich intellectual tradition. Raise hand, who does not agree? They have so thoroughly discussed, you know. This occurs how, why? Psychologists should be ready to know this. The fault may be with the object, the fault may be with your mind, the fault may be with the process. N number of factors are contributing for these illusions or false cognition. All have been discussed. Whether you agree with this or not, you see. The tradition has all along been a mode of dialogical discourse. It is this mode that added depth to classical epistemology. At the beginning, the question, the inquiry has been, what is the source of this brutality? And if you summarize answers, I find two answers are coming again and again. One is that the plurality has emerged from singularity, one answer. And the other is the plurality has emerged from plurality. Now, I take these two variables as a logician, and four possible pairs will be played. Oh, so I can see, now look, let's cut short. I read, and the formulation that I have made, I read each pair I am reading. Just watch how I am reading. B is plurality. A is the source similarity. Okay? I am reading the first pair. A, the plurality has evolved from singularity. So if the singularity is real, the plurality has also to be real. This view is of Vallabhacharya, Shuddhadvaita. Second pair I'm reading, no, reality is only one, the plurality is superimposed on one. Abhyasa. So, the plurality is a superimposition of similarity. This is Shankaracharya. The third pair I am reading, no, my friend, the plurality has not come from singularity, but plurality has come from
plurality.
Nyaya and others. And the fourth pair is the plurality has evolved neither from singularity nor from plurality of the type posited by the three previous pairs.
They are Buddhists.
Pratitya samutpada. Now multiple positions, therefore they will take. So remember, when I take a position, I have worldview. In terms of my worldview, I take a position. Is it true or not? So both falsity and truthfulness, both are intrinsic. So there will be two variables, four positions, four possibilities. All the four possibilities have been discussed. Threadbare. I skip. Illusion and hallucination. Many times, all illusions are sadhisthana brahma. Adhisthana, you need X. X as Y. But niradhisthana, I have explained it. Sadhisthana, brahma, these are the examples. Jotted down in 9th century AD. Bhaskara, kirana, jalavagama. Miras, water. Jalada, gandharva, nagara, varna. Jalada is cloud. And seeing the structure of the cloud, you have seen, oh, this is the palace of in the heaven. Gandharva Nagara. Then Raju Bhujaka Grahana, the Sarpa and Raju, rope and snake, my friend, no relief. In this way, almost all types of error, or illusion, or misapprehension, or hallucination have been discussed in the classical Indian tradition. My only desire is expressed in the question. Should it not form part of our contemporary mainstream education? I want answer from you before you ask.